Look, now I love discussing obscure West Coast religious cults just as much as the next man, Hilary, but the reason you're in Sydney was to talk to one of the most recognisable faces in the world.
That's right. Jane Fonda really is one of the most famous and enduring actors of our time. And at the age of 80, yes, it's hard to believe she is actually 80, the two-time Academy Award winner has packed so much more than movies into her life.
That's right. She's on her way to New Zealand for a one-night-only show to talk about her extraordinary journey. Hilary got a sneak peek on the Sydney leg of her tour this afternoon.
You might have thought at 80 Jane Fonda would be ready for retirement, but it turns out she's still got stuff to do.
You actually retired in the 1990s, and I'm interested, what happened to that?
In my 60s, I made a comeback, starting with a film called Monster-in-Law, and then it went on from there. And I can't believe I'm 80 now, and I have a hit movie and a hit TV series, and I feel very blessed.
Since her retirement, she's been busier than ever. The critically acclaimed Grace and Frankie's done 4 seasons, and there's a new movie just out, Book Club.
I would like to introduce you to Christian Grey.
Oh, no.
We started this book club to stimulate our minds.
From what I hear, this book is quite stimulating.
How wonderful it is to be part of a movie that embraces and celebrates older women.
It's a thrill to be able to play, you know, robust, fun, active women who are older.
Jane Fonda is Hollywood royalty. No, seriously. When she was born, her parents named her Lady Jane Seymour Fonda. Her father, actor Henry Fonda, exposed a young Jane to some of Hollywood's most glamorous leading ladies.
One of those stars was Greta Garbo, and the pair of you actually went skinny dipping together at one point.
What I really appreciated was when she dropped her bathrobe, that it was an athletic body. It was not a Playboy body. The water was so cold, and she just dove in. You know, I was like putting my toe. I also skinny dipped with Michael Jackson, but not at the same time.
She followed her dad into films and, like him, won 2 Academy Awards for her acting.
While we were making the movie, we all became more aware of the problems of the handicapped.
Fighting for others has always been a huge part of Jane Fonda's life.
Any healthy country, like any healthy individual, should be in perpetual revolution, perpetual change.
She opposed the Vietnam War and campaigned hard on issues involving women and the environment. But it was her 1972 visit to Hanoi that caused the most controversy. Dubbed Hanoi Jane, she was photographed sitting on a Vietnamese anti-aircraft gun. Some labelled her actions treasonous. But young and naive, Jane Fonda says she was set up, and she regrets it.
It was awful. It was terrible because it wasn't my intention. I had been working with GIs for several years before I went there, and I made Coming Home. But it was what it was. The image is there, and it will be until I die and beyond. And I'm really sorry about that.
When we are equal, we are not abused. This kind of change doesn't come about just through protest. It happens through organizing.
Organizing is what she's good at. When she needed to fund causes she believed in, she started making exercise videos.
Are you ready to do the workout?
Her 1982 Jane Fonda workout video is the biggest selling VHS of all time. The healthy living stood her in good stead. Let's be honest, she looks pretty amazing for 80. And as for retirement,
any immediate plans to retire?
What's that word? Retire from what? I enjoy so much what I do. I intend to be active until I can't be anymore.
Well.
And then I want my children to put me down and put me in a biodegradable pot and bury me and have flowers grow.
Well, that sounds beautiful. And we're all delighted that you have no plans to retire because none of us want it to happen.
Thanks.
She is truly such a remarkable woman. So she's got a one-woman show tonight here in Sydney, and then tomorrow night in Melbourne, and then she's popping across to New Zealand for a show on Thursday. But it is really remarkable to think that she is 80.
Yeah,
and she's still working so hard, and she's so fit. And it just goes to prove that those fitness videos, Jeremy, they work. So get on your leg warmers.
Yeah, well, you and Jane got on like a house on fire. Did she give you a number, or did you get a room, or what happened after the interview?
No, nothing.
Really?
Sadly, nothing.
Okay. No.